Hello, hello, hello. And welcome to Let's Play Final Fantasy XIV Patch 4.5, A Requiem for Heroes. Alright. Episode 9 of Beetlejuice Deedlejuice Volume 4. Let us begin. Okay. Here we are. Right where we left off. I'm ready to pick up the first quest. Prelude and Violet.
I'm glad you've come, though I'm afraid there's little in the way of good news. After you left, we reached out to both the Alchemist's Guild and Stillglade Fane and attempted all manner of treatments. But the results were always the same. Whatever the answer is, it's not alchemy or conjuring. Why did it have to be Yshtola and Rianger and not me? Out of all of us, they are the ones who could feasibly have solved this puzzle. I know for you still missing. God, it's going on. Where do we even start? A grave situation indeed. Might I be of some assistance? Cryo, I thought you busy delving into the mysteries of Eureka. When word reached me of the plight of our friends, I could not well stay away. As a fellow Scion, not to mention your erstwhile mentor, this is one of those times you should feel free to call on me, regardless of my personal circumstances. Yes, I should have thought of that. Thank you for coming, Kryle. We would welcome your insight. And I should be happy to provide it. Now, what's this I hear about Alphano heading into Imperial territory? That boy always did have some funny ideas. Do you remember the speech he gave when he was accepted to the Studium? My life's goal is not less than the salvation of this star. Has been a source of great embarrassment to him, as you know. But the fact of the matter is, he meant every word and has lived his life accordingly. Yes, he remains altruistic to a fault, but I'm worried he was too fixated on his goals to see the dangers, as has happened before. You needn't be so concerned. Though his values remain the same, Alphano is not the blinkered boy he once was. Slowly but surely, his eyes have been opened. Thanks to a certain someone. A certain someone whom he'd be mortified to learn had heard about his little speech. Mum's the word, eh? Right, I'd better have a look at our patients. They're in the infirmary, I assume. I'll need absolute quiet, so it would be best if I did this alone. If you'll excuse me. All three are in fine physical health. At a glance, I would say they were merely sound asleep. for the fact that I couldn't sense the slightest trace of them in their bodies. It's as if their souls have taken leave of their physical forms. Ah, yes. The Elder Seedseer made a similar observation. I've read the report. When you heard this mysterious voice, you described feeling as if you were somewhere else, yes? If we assume the ether which comprises your essence is being drawn to some other place, then it may be possible to follow the trail it leaves behind, just as we did in our search for Thancred. I wasn't around for that, but I can't imagine it was easy. Oh, it wasn't. But that's no reason not to try. I will have need of Master Matoya's crystal eye if I'm even to make the attempt. So, I suggest we pay her a visit.
Oh, great. Actually, I'm going to go to Aldar real quick. Actually, no, I'm not. Just gotta check out my retainers real quick. Someone sold something. A big ticket item? No, not really. Okay, my controls are all screwed up. This looks kinda lame-ish. And this is a bogus fucking bunch of bullshit. We're just gonna sell this ass, stupid ass piece of shit. This too? Yeah. I wish I was doing something really cool right now. Yeah, that's what I was looking for. No, that's not what I was looking for. Maybe it's on the... Why is this re... Why is this... Damn it, this is gonna drive me insane. Okay, and I screwed up that. This is a great song, huh? Alright, well, I guess I gotta get used to it. At least this isn't screwed up. Hang on a damn second. This is the thrilling excitement of a Requiem for Heroes. Okay, screw this. Chromite ingot. Let's see what I can sell it for. Not too shabby. Okay. This is seriously driving me insane. I'm gonna look something up. Okay, I'm just gonna go to a little thing I like to call Discord. I guess I could have gone to the Novice Network, but whatever. Whatever. This is the thrilling window character camera configuration tutorial walkthrough. Witness as I bungle through menus of settings. Alright, I gotta get out of here because this song is good and I do not want it to be droned out. Okay, these controls are backwards too. What the hell? There we go. There we go. What does this do? I don't think we need to. Oh, what the hell? Okay. What is going on, Mr. Pedekin? Or Mrs.? I don't know. That is a non-gendered name, I feel like. I don't mean to insult you at all. How is your morning going, regardless? I'm gonna stop dilly-dallying and shilly-shallying and get to the action of this stinking stream. Finally, I don't know how long I've been going, probably like a half hour now. I haven't done anything yet.
Again, have you? I hide myself away in a cave, and still you people insist on pestering me with your problems.
I'm gonna do something real quick here.
Oh, I mistook you for young what's his name, but I see now you're the sister. Weren't you supposed to be the lively one? I've seen happier faces at a rain-sodden burial.
Okay, sorry about that. Okay, I think everything is going okay.
But the situation isn't exactly conducive to gaiety.
That's more like it. Stoller used to spit and hiss like a wildcat, too. Better for a young thing like you to be filled with fire and leave the doom and gloom to your elders. Now, what exactly does this tragic situation of yours have to do with me?
If I may, Master Matoya, we have need of your crystal eye once more.
And Stola is one of the afflicted, is she? She may be an ungrateful stray, but she's my ungrateful stray, and I'll not see her buried before I am.
Right. Let us see what we can see. I'll begin from where our friends first fell, and cast my senses out from there. No closer to an answer than when we started. But knowing their souls are still out there is progress of a sort. We just have to keep looking. Pray, excuse me a moment. Yes? I remember, but... What, to Alamigo? We're on our way. Apparently, a group of Populares have defected to Alamigo, and Maxima, the envoy Alphano left with, is one of them. I'm sorry. I realize we've barely begun here, but...
Go, child, go! You've made up your mind, and life's too short for dithering.
I'll do some digging in the meantime and see if there isn't some other method we could use to continue the search. Let's be off then.
What happened to the moon?
Not again. The enchantment barely seems to take these days. I chalk it up to old age, but I rather doubt it's that simple.
took ill. Yshtola and Arianger were sharing notes on a thinning of the ether. It seems to be happening all over.
Does it now? And here I was, all set to blame my woes on that creaking mountain of refuse clogging up the Thaliac. I fear something has gone awry. Still, there's naught to be gained from starting in shadows. You can only do what can be done, and that but one thing at a time.
Okay, well, I think I'm going to end the episode here. Yeah, this is a really piss-poor beginning to this whole quest line. This whole 4.5 excitement, but it's about that time. It's about my breakfast time, so thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye!